Miss Sherwood-chan?
Mr. Chairman, since 1993, ASEAN countries have grown in total trade from US$400 billion to $2.5 trillion. Looking at the figures, this economic growth is impressive and the poverty rate amongst our neighboring countries has been declining. When ASEAN Vision 2020 was established, one of the key objectives was to enhance economic growth and deepen intra-regional trade ties, with free movement of people, goods, services and investment capital in ASEAN. As it stands, the ASEAN intra-trade is still weak. While Singapore is one of the most open economies in ASEAN, our trade with other ASEAN states are just about a quarter of our total trade. In a world that's becoming more protectionist and mercantilist, all the more reason for ASEAN to accelerate economic integration. Can ministers share what are some of the challenges to this integration? Based on conventional wisdom, it is likely that having an open, competitive and integrated ASEAN implies better chances of new industries to establish in our part of the world. If this outcome is within reach, how then can our workers tap upon this opportunity to expand their working scope and skills?